Mike, thanks. We want to get a little perspective on what actually took place at Davis. Former Sacramento County Sheriff John McGinness, now current talk show host with KFBK, is joining us from the KCRA 3 newsroom. So let's talk about your reaction to what you saw in the video and then what you've seen in terms of kind of the fallout since that time.
Good morning, Deirdre. First of all, what you see in the video, I think, speaks for itself, but it leaves a whole lot of other questions unanswered, specifically context. In what context was the pepper spray applied? And I think that has to be addressed.
Well, what do you mean the context of that, John? I mean, I'm watching them spray students there at pretty short range.
Yeah, what was the intent? What communication had they had with the protesters prior to the use of the pepper spray? And frankly, I don't know the answer to that question. But if their purposes were simply to deal with an annoyance and get them out of the way, then obviously they're going to have problems down the road. If, however, their plan was to effectuate an arrest, and they made due notice to them that, hey, look, this is the these are going to be the consequences for your continued failure to comply with our lawful directives. You're going to experience pain. You're going to experience discomfort. It's either going to be in the form of compliance control holds or perhaps batons or pepper spray. Mm-hmm. By the way, the one that has the least in terms of lasting implications, then that puts in an entirely different set of circumstances. I think you expand that issue of context a bit, too, and look across the country where things have broken terribly badly in different venues where, frankly, the police have failed to seize control of the protesters or the occupiers.
Okay.
So I think there is a need for them to control that campus.
And that's an interesting point. So the other question, I guess, would be, would officers have gone ahead and done the spraying without a direct order from the police chief or the university president, or is that kind of your call in the field based on what was discussed before you even got there?
Yeah, absolutely. The officers should have that's how police officers function. Quite honestly, they function as executives. They're given policies, procedure manuals, statutory law, case law, and then they go implement those rules as they see fit given the nature of the circumstances. Now, there can be absolute orders given from on high. Do not under any circumstances use pepper spray. Do not, or do, or whatever the case may be. And none of us knows any of that at this juncture. So the final outcome could very well be that they were found to be excessive in their use of force. But my strong suspicion is that there was a message conveyed that their plan was to actually take custody of these people, and that would make that a very lawful use of pepper spray.
Yeah, I mean, bottom line, they don't want it getting to that point, right?
They do not. And I think also you have to consider the mindset of those who are there to protest. It's not like they're simply trying to pass through or be involved in typical criminal activity and get away with it. Their purpose was very likely a mindset that ended with them being arrested. And arrest comes with the physical taking into custody of the offender. And with that, you have to understand that oftentimes, especially when you have, even if it's passive resistance, the only way to make them move context is to use some kind of a pain compliance technique. And I think pepper spray, given the, remember what it is too, it's oleoresin capsicum, which is basically, it is pepper spray. It's a spice that people use in food.
Yes, but it's miserable.
It is absolutely
All
miserable.
All right, that's former Sheriff.